Good day everybody. In this video I will explain how we can estimate Poisson's ratio and swell modulus. These are two values very important in swell mechanics because it will show how much deformation soil will undergo under a certain stress. So in this case we will use two formulas. This one for Poisson's ratio, you see there are a few symbols here. Don't be scared, I'm going to explain what it means. So this value is Poisson's ratio, and to know Poisson's ratio we need to know two principal stresses. Sigma 1 is major principal stress and sigma 3 is minor principal stress, and we also need to measure deformation. So you see this epsilon 1 and epsilon 3. So these are the values of deformation that soil undergoes during a triaxial test. Now let's look at this formula before we start doing example. So this how we estimate soil modulus. You also probably have heard of Young's modulus, so that's the same thing. In this case we need to know again principal stresses, and we're going to get these principal stresses from the experiment, and we also need to know Poisson's ratio, and we need to know epsilon 1. Okay, now let's see what we can do with these particular examples that we have here. We have a curve from a triaxial test. So this is triaxial test when we have compound pressure. So if we look at the sample and before we actually perform any test, we're going to apply first confining pressure. And this is what we also call sigma 3. And in this case, for this particular case, sigma 3, let's say, was 30 kPa. So we apply sigma 3, which is 30. And we consolidate the sample, and after that we apply deviator stress. So in this case, we're just going to say sigma 1. And then we apply the stress until soil fails. What is going to happen with the soil is going to deform, so it's kind of going to have shape like this. So you see this deformation will be deformation through major axes, vertical deformation, we call it epsilon 1, and this deformation, this one is radial deformation, epsilon 3. So in this case it's going to be always negative because it's going to be an expansion. So this is the setup of the test that now we're going to look at, and we will look at these two curves. So this one I will show you change in the principal stress. So this is major principal stress here. And as already mentioned, that confining pressure doesn't change during the experiment, and we keep it 30 kPa. So what we're going to do right now, we're going to estimate the Poisson's ratio for this soil for point A. Why do we choose point A? Because it's on this straight linear line where we still have linear deformation, so elastic deformation. And we're also going to look at the changes in the shape of the sample, so the strain. So this is a vertical strain, so vertical or like axial epsilon 1, and this one is radial strain, that's epsilon 3. So what we're going to get from this curve is we're going to get values of sigma 1 and sigma 3. So sigma 1, it is 80, so 80 kPa. Sigma 3, we already know that we set it up before we applied sigma 1 is 30 kPa. And now let's estimate what is going to be strains at when we reach point A. So we know that the axial strain epsilon 1 will be 0.01, and now we have to estimate here what is going to be radial strain. Radial strain will be negative 0.003. So that's my estimations. Okay, so using this data now, let's estimate the Poisson's ratio. And we're just going to use the formula. So Poisson's ratio is equal negative. Radial strain is negative 0.003 times measure principal stress, which is 80, plus axial deformation, which is 0.01 times minor principal stress 30, divided by, I'm gonna put numbers here, 0.01 times 80 plus 0.01 times 30 and minus 2, and we have negative epsilon 3, which is 0.003, and we're gonna multiply it by minor principal stress, which is 30 kPa. Okay, according to my calculations, it should be 0.42. Okay, remember that the maximum Poisson's ratio is 0.5. If you get something more than 0.5, it means that you made a mistake. You have to check your calculations. And now let's estimate cell modulus value, which is capital E. So in this case, major principal stress is 80 minus 2 times Poisson's ratio, we just found it, 0.42, and times minor principal stress, which is 30. And axial deformation, we already know, is going to be 0.01. So it should be, the answer should be in kPa, kilopascals. It will be 4,468.8 kPa. So that's how we analyze data from triaxial test. So just remember that it's for triaxial test. It's not for unconfined compression test, because for that test, the analysis will be different. So this is what we do for triaxial test. That's how we estimate this two important properties of the soil. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.